I was just reading, and then first four men came to my tent to ask about my details. And then half an hour later, there was a police officer came to my tent. And now he says I have to come with him to the police station. This place is not safe for me. So I have to break up this tent and get all my stuff.
Hello, my name is Bas Itzinger, and I'm traveling around the world by bicycle. And in this video series, I'll show you my adventures. And in this video, I cycle from the north of Spain to Portugal, back to Spain and Morocco. This is Cycle Around the World Part 3, between Mediterranean cities and mountains.
I just entered the city of Pontevedra. I'm gonna continue to Vigo. I'm gonna stay there with a host. And tomorrow I will go to Portugal.
Mountains and cities. The contrast between them is like day and night. Crowd versus loneliness. Culture versus nature. Houses versus trees. People versus animals. Entering cities by bicycle is difficult sometimes. But once you get in the city, it is often rewarded by the beauty of the city. And some of the most beautiful cities were on my path, so I took the chance to visit them. But therefore, I first need to cycle a lot of kilometers.
Misfits, quiet room. San Francisco. What the hell was all talking round? Is it now sunny California? Wait.
So actually, over there, the hills, there you can see Portugal. It's divided by a river. But I'm gonna eat a salad first with spinach. So yes, I'm just riding towards Portugal via this bridge. So right now I am walking up a hill in Portugal because I need to find a place to sleep, and according to my navigation there is a waterfall just real close, so I'm gonna check it out. So there actually is a waterfall, and I'm gonna sleep right here. Well, since it was a warm day today, I need to have a shower. Woo! Yeah! Whoa! Woo! I think it is just a really good finish of a really good day, because I think it's one of my best days so far, because in the morning I could have the food I want. I did do some editing for my video. I just take it easy, and then I had a really good route along the coast, and there was no troubles with my bike. I was able to do some good groceries. I crossed a new country and I slept next to a waterfall. It's so cool. I hope more of these days will come. I I guess there will be tough days too, but yeah, I like this.
So I woke up with this view, and over there you see the waterfall. I heard its noise all night, but it was all right.
What's up, duck? No, sorry. Okay, I go. I thought you wanted to be friends. Okay, sorry. Goodbye. Goodbye. Oh man, you should know how much I want to be in that swimming pool. It's getting hotter day by day, and wow, it looks so good. It's really hot now, and yeah, I would like to have a dive in this one, but unfortunate, I continue.
During my second day in Portugal, I cycled to Braga, a city more than 2,000 years old. My warm showers host showed me the beauty of Bom Jesus, which lies at the top of a mountain near the city. Now you've gone, after all we've known, after all that I've been told, California's cold.
This morning I left Braga, and now I'm cycling towards Porto, the next city I go to. The day is beautiful again, and yeah, let's see what today brings. Very nice road, very green, no cars.
Entering the city of Porto, the second largest city of the country, was once again a disaster. But wow! Once I got in the city, cycling on one of the stately bridges, I really got struck by the fine beauty of the city. Absolutely amazing. All annoyances of the past hour thrown away by one look towards the skyline. I spent two nights here to get a glimpse of the structured chaos, street artists, and the ongoing stream of tourists, and to get dissolved by the city. And after visiting a few big cities in a row, I felt it was time for more mountains. So I followed the river Douro to find a different kind of beauty. So between the trees of my camping spot, I made this new design with my solar panel on the back, which is going to a power bank, which is in this bag, and then goes by cable all the way to my phone for navigation, because I am almost out of energy, and the dynamo
doesn't always work, especially in the mountains. Okay, my phone seems to charge, so the setup, it's working. And now I'm cycling to my new host, but first I have to race more than 1,000 meters in one go. So it's gonna be a hell of a tough climb. Yeah. Well, I found myself a new camping spot. It's quite nice. It's between two mountains in a valley. There is a small house up there. I'm just gonna check it out. If there's nothing, if there's no one there, then I'm gonna camp here. Looks really good, but it's a farmland because there is some plantation and there's some human activity. So I have to be sure I can go here. But yeah, looks good. So I made myself a nice little fire. Now I'm gonna put some corn on top of it to make it hot, and that's gonna be dinner for tonight. This is the second time I use this tool, so I still have to get used to it. I don't have any gas or gasoline. I only carry this. It's very light. It saves me a lot of extra stuff, like a cooking system and a pan and refueling for gas. So yeah, I hope it's gonna work. Seems to be good. Yes, it is cooking. So my dinner is ready.
My next destination is Campo Mayor, where my aunt and uncle run a camping.
Okay, I just made it to Campo Mayor, so now I'm going to cycle to the campsite. So this is the camping, Os Años. It's actually pretty crowded. I didn't expect this at all. Hello. Kijk. And now I'm here. I'm going to set up my tent and I'm gonna be happy.
Campo Mayor is a beautiful and small city, and I stayed here for 3 nights. I found it a real pleasure to be among family and to rest for a bit. I went to visit the Chapel of Bones, which has bones of about 400 persons. They are placed in this chapel as a memorial of a giant explosion of an ammunition base in which the persons died.
So I'm back on the road. I stayed for 2 days at my aunt and uncle's camping in Campo Mayor at camping Os Años.
My feelings is not what I'm the best at. I've never taught you many things that I should. There were tar on my lips, time to tell you the truth. I'll make it quick for you to know. Splashing my feelings is not what I'm the best at. I've never taught you many things that I should. There were tar on my lips, time to tell you the truth. I've been on the road now, coming home to my old town. This pretty smile, this pretty face, thinking I'm the happiest man. I've been on the road now, coming home to my old
town. So I'm now cycling on some kind of red clay. It's really difficult, I cannot get forward because there is too much friction. This stuff is too sticky. So I guess I have to walk this part. No, I'm not gonna do that. I'm just gonna walk. I'm gonna bring the bags over there, then I'll bring the bike over there, because this is not possible. I just walked that road to here. This is a gravel road, and from here on I think I can cycle again, I hope. I see a bridge over there, and I think I'm going to the asphalt right now, so let's hope so, because this is a little bit exhausting and cost me too much time. So my tent is set up, the fire is on. I'm going to clean my bike. It's ready, and yesterday I bought this new pot and I'm gonna try it today. I bought some lentils with chorizo, so let's see how this is gonna taste.
It's okay, I know someday I'm gonna be with you. It's okay, I know someday I'm gonna be with you.
I'm now almost in the city of Sevilla, and I heard that Sevilla is a good city for cycling, and so it seems, because there's actually a cycle path leading into the city.
Okay, this is the road I have to take to find a camping spot. I have to follow the road over there. It looks really promising. I think this is one of the better roads I've seen so far. So, yeah. But I have to be quick because the sun, it's almost down. It goes down pretty fast in here. So, I need to make some progress.
So today I'm going to enter Morocco, yeah!
I come in peace! What? Holy shit!
I'm on the beach, yeah! And I cannot go here without going to swim.
It's okay.
Okay, so now it's time to try a little bit to enjoy, and then I go to the ferry. It's still 5 kilometers from here. It's over there. There are a lot of kite surfers. That's really cool to see. The weather is great, and I think in 3 hours I will be in Morocco.
Morocco, a new country in a new continent with a new culture. The country of great mountain ranges, a Sahara, rich traditions. How is this going to be?
Okay, so I just arrived in Morocco with the ferry. I still have to get out.
All right, I made it to Morocco.
Hello!
This morning I left the hostel in Tangier to go south.
So that car over there, he just passed me and he saw me sitting here in this bus shelter and he gave me 2 bananas. Wow! Just in the middle of nowhere. Okay, it's unbelievable.
I am being attacked by a dog.
I just entered this small town and I asked a man if there's a place to sleep, but he didn't speak English or French, only Arabic, and he brought me to another guy who spoke French. I think he's from the city hall. He couldn't speak English either, but I think they will offer me a place to sleep at their house and also a shower. But they just got in a car and drove away, and not sure if I have to follow them, but I will see. They already made a photo of my passport. It's what they do here, I heard. They make a lot of photos from the passport or copies. Okay, not too bad. They let me stay here on this piece of grass with these two fellows. They are like little dogs. Oh, shouldn't come too close. Yeah, nice first real day in Morocco.
Okay, so it's 9 p.m. It's dark already, and I was just reading, and then first 4 men came to my tent to ask about my details. And then half an hour later, there was a police officer came to my tent. He just watched my passport and he called someone. And a lot of crazy stuff. And now he says I have to come with him to the police station. This place is not safe for me. So I have to
break up this tent and get all my stuff and move. It's gonna be something.
Okay, you probably don't see me, but I'm now cycling again in the dark after breaking up my tent. I'm following a police car, which is not really an official police car. So it's a little bit strange.
So they brought me here to the police station. This is where I slept last night. They said it would be safer here, inside the gates of the police station. The guy told me to put my bike against the building. And then at 1 a.m. in the night, there was another man and I recognized him. He took my bike and put it inside. And I was not happy with that because I didn't know what he was gonna do with it. Yeah, I'm gonna check it out now. It's in the morning and I'm gonna leave, so. So, right there is my tent. And that is the police station. Like, there is a car. And this is the gate.
Okay, I got my bike back. That's good. Now I'm still drying my tent. Cycling in the mountains, it's really good. It's a small road, just a few cars, and it's a great view. It's absolutely beautiful.
So I'm now in this restaurant. There you see the pan of soup. I'm gonna get my bike parked here. So it looks good. What is the name?
Beisar. Our language is the Beisar.
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 So it's 9 in the morning and I'm on the road again because this time is the most reasonable of the whole day. So I tried to leave early.
And I'm like now on my way to Chef Chouin. It must be somewhere there.
They asked for my passport and they asked me what my job was. I told them I was an engineer. Everything was okay. But then they were just having lunch and he invited me to have some as well. He gave me a bottle of water, some bread, some fries, a Coca-Cola. Wow, it's a good hospitality. And yeah, didn't expect it at all. I thought it was screwed. I would now have some kind of a police escort. So just at the end of the day, I wanted to take a side road. And then two men stopped me in one car. And they told me I couldn't go here. I guess they might be from the hotel from the previous village. And now they're actually following me. Follow me to the place I was aiming at to camp, because then I'm not able to camp and I probably have to cycle all the way back. So this is the car that's following me. It's I don't know, it's real strange. They stop, then they drive behind me, then
in front of me, and it's late already. This is not what I expected at the end of this day. It was such a good day with the police officer, gave me some lunch, and now this. It's really strange. Shit. Fuck.
I guess I'm a little bit lucky because I got some problems with my bike, so I had to stop for a while. Then the car who followed me passed me, and then I met this other guy, and he's willing to take me to his home. And the car that followed me, he didn't really see me, so I hope that this is all right.
Groves. Tom maand kom ik erop heb.
So this man, he helped me out yesterday. He invited me to his house, his family's house, and he's been a wonderful host, just out of the blue. And yeah, thank you, man.
Thank you.
Shukra. So I found a guy. He brought me to the his house, but we have to go back by taxi. So we put on the bike on the roof of the taxi. So this is the house where I'm staying. It's a small farm in a small village. This is Aziz. He hosts me, and this is the house I sleep.
Hey, doggy. What's up, duck?
So I can park my bike inside. Here are my bags. This is gonna be my bed. And now I'm gonna have a shower in here, which is a bucket of water and just a room.
Internet, no? Connexio.
Internet.
And today I'm cycling to Fes, which is one of the big cities in Morocco. So I just entered this school, a lot of kids, just out of the blue. And now I get a free tour. All I can say about Morocco is that it is a great country. The people are very warm-hearted. Their nature is of absolute beauty. And yes, sometimes they act a little bit strange. But that is a story told by a foreigner, a stranger on a bike. And I can't wait to see what things will cross my path in the next few weeks of this amazing country. So today I have a rest day, I'm in Fes. They have 600 of these small alleys. It's amazing. Most of them, they have a dead end. So it's really difficult to find the good ways to some other places. But yeah, it's good to get lost in the cities. And yeah, it's good to see some of the culture from the big cities. I really like it. And I'm gonna get lost. Woo, yeah.